in about the Christmas time, when green leaves they were falling, when Lord John Hugh of the North Country fell in love with Barbara Allen. He sent his servants night and day to the house where she was dwelling, saying, "Please, Miss Rice, come to my master's side, if your name be Barbara Allen." Slowly, slowly she arose, and slowly she put on her, and slowly to his bedside she goes. "I fear, young man, you're dying. I'm sick, and I'm very bad. The grave shall be my dwelling. One kiss from your ruby lips would save me, love, from dying. One kiss you never will get. You are no other man breathing. One kiss you never will get, if your heart's blood was a-spilling. Oh, don't you remember, oh," then she said, "down in yon alehouse drinking, when you drank the health of all fair maids and slighted Barbara Allen?" "I do remember, oh," then he said, "down in yon alehouse drinking, when I drank the health of all fair maids and my love to Barbara Allen." "Do you remember, oh," then she said, "down in yon garden walking, when you plucked a rose for all fair maids and slighted Barbara Allen?" "I do remember, oh," then he said, "down in yon garden walking, when I plucked a rose for all fair maids and my love to Barbara Allen. Look up at my bedhead, and there you'll find it hanging, my golden watch and my silver penknife that I leave to Barbara Allen. Look down at my bedside, it's there you'll find it sitting, a china basin full of tears that was shed for Barbara Allen." He turned his pale face to the wall, and death came slowly creeping. These were the very last words he said, "Adieu, young Barbara Allen." As she was walking her father's grove, she met his funeral coming. Lay down, my lovely corpse, till I gaze once more upon him." The more she gazed, the more she laughed, while his kind friends were sighing. They then took up the corpse with shame, saying, "Hard-hearted Barbara Allen. Oh, mother, mother, make my bed, and make it long and narrow, for a young man died for me today, and I'll die for him tomorrow. Oh, brothers, brothers, dig my grave, and they get deep and narrow, for a young man died for me today, and I'll die for him tomorrow. And one was buried in Mary's churchyard, and the other in Nelson's choir, and out of one there grew a rose, and out of the other a briar. The briar grew long and the rose grew tall, until they met together, and there they formed a true lover's knot, and there they remain forever.